Time now. If you have been inspired by programs like Who Do You Think You Are? And have researched your family tree, then chances are you need the help of the Archive Service.
I always listen to you, Charlie. Archivists think that most of us have no idea what information is out there, so this week they're opening their doors as part of a campaign to raise awareness of the services that are on offer.
Breakfast in Muffet is at one of the places that's usually only open by appointment. It's a rather special place, isn't it, Tim?
Morning.
Yes, good. Indeed, yes. Good morning to you from the Royal College of Obstetricians and Gynaecologists in central London on what is the start of Explore Your Archive. More than 200 organisations across the UK and Ireland are this week opening up their archives to help people become inspired by the past, learn a little bit about the world we live in today by looking back. So we've got plenty of objects here which do just that. Let's have a quick chat to Jeff, who's the Chief Executive of the National Archives. Jeff, what's the idea behind this week?
Well, as you say, this is archives across the nation opening up their doors, reminding people what energetic, vibrant spaces they are. We've got events and activities across the country, starting at Exeter, where you can look at Saxon charters at the cathedral, going to the research library at Birmingham, and taking your artefacts to Glasgow City Archives. So events across the country, trying to say to the public, now is a great time to start your research.
OK, thanks very much indeed, Jeff. It's amazing who you bump into in this place. Look, it's actor Stephen McGann, star, of course, of Call the Midwife, and Penny, who's an archivist here as well. Stephen, when you researched your character, how important was this place?
This place is wonderful. This is everything to do with the hard line of midwifery, all the midwifery stuff which the doctor needs to know about on Call the Midwife. The favourite thing for me is not so much the facts and figures, which were amazing, and I did lots of work on finding out what levels of poverty and things like that, but it was the objects that really moved me. The things an actor really loves. How heavy is the bag to carry? How do you operate the gas and air machine? These objects, which all these archives can contain, can give you the real living facts of what it was like to do that kind of a job back then.
And how important is it that we understand and learn about the past and become inspired by it?
It's so important. The thing is, people did things in a certain way back then, but they were just like us. They lived, they thought, they cared. If we lose a track of what is in our archives, we lose our own memory. We lose a sense of who we are as a nation. And what made us who we are today, what made us who we are, is ordinary people, and you'll find them in here.
Penny, you're an archivist here.
I am.
It's not just actors who are coming along, is it? You want everyone to along and learn about the past.
We have academics, students come in, family historians. If you have a midwife in the family, what you want to know is what they did, what it was like to actually be a midwife at a certain time. And that's what we can provide them with.
So this week, places like this opening their doors, and it's the second year this has been running, isn't it? Have you been surprised as to how much interest you've had last year and hopefully this year as well?
Oh, the interest has been much more this year. I think as a profession, archivists have really got on the back of this now, and small archives like here can really, really show what stories we've got.
How have programmes like Who Do You Think You Are, how have they changed things, do you think?
Massively. I think with the online resources that are available, people can find things much easier.
That's how I started. I looked at my family tree and it led to dramas. In the 90s, I did a drama with my brothers based upon what I found. I found someone in my family tree who was on the Titanic, of all places. And I found that all myself. It was like this most fascinating detective work that I think in shows like Who Do You Think You Are, everybody's beginning to get the bug. But you even find something wonderful like here, like Penny showed me before. There's a woman here giving birth during the war in an air raid shelter. And they're having to send out for someone because the bombs are falling. Now, this isn't just facts and figures. This is drama. This is human life. You can't get anything more exciting than this. It's wonderful.
It brings the past alive, doesn't it? Thanks very much indeed. Well, the week is called Explore Your Archive. And say more than 200 organisations across the UK doing what they're doing here, opening up the archives to the public.
Oh, thank you very much, Tim. It's been fascinating watching that all morning. And.